This is Houston. Say again, please.
Houston, we've had a problem.
Hey there, folks. Welcome to part 19 of Witcher 3. And Triss and Albert have just ridden off into the sunset, but not like that, because he's a bit of a dweeb. And we are heading towards Skellige. We're getting back into the main story now. We're going to use this signpost here to get ourselves back to... Oh, I've got a new marker there. We are on the map, by the way, just in case you're interested. It's an area I kind of rode towards before and we couldn't get in. And that's where the garden party was, just in there. So we're going to fast travel from this very fine signpost here and find ourselves a boat going to Skellige, which is any of these, really. So the closest one is there. Off we go. Good little side stories there we did in section 18. So we didn't see any of the main story that I remember, but they all attached themselves onto the side of it. Very good. A little bit of love interest with Triss there. That'll surely build up later. I'm pretty sure we're going to get to the end of this story and we'll have to choose between two or three of these ladies as to which one captures our heart the most. Okay, let's get on with it.
Oh my god, a reaper's come for me.
Oh, mini-maps, oh there we go. I was going to say it hasn't loaded there, but that's just done it. Let's find ourselves a boat. Ooh, always love the sight of these ships. Ooh, strumpet. Waiting for the sailors, my love.
I can see it in your face.
I don't want to die!
What?
You're so rough.
The hell are they all screaming for?
Ah!
Gonna kill you!
Yeah, alright. I'll take your crowns, I think. Not that I need them, it's only a few in each, isn't there? Captain... Ooh, hello.
Who's captain of this ship?
Looking at her. I. Her. That's right. I, a woman, am captain. Shocking as shit, I know.
I like your style. We're going with you.
Need to get to Skellige.
Not on this boat.
Oh, God's sake.
The islanders live off plundering the seas. Not willing to risk that.
Ever sailed there?
Listen, the islanders attack all ships. When they hate someone, Nilfgaard, for instance, they attack him more. But truth be told, not much more. Loaded me once. Expect they wanted to see if I had captain's bollocks. That spot of fun gave me enough Skellige for a lifetime.
All right then. Keep your boat then. See if I care. Right. Let's find another boat. Choice of two here now, by the looks of it. Yeah, we've got one circle here. Where was the other boat then? Must be the other side of the harbour. Who's captain? There be a door. It be locked. God damn it. Where's your captain? Speak to one of these dudes.
this deck's to shine like the silver on the Emperor's table.
No clue. Drinking somewheres, I reckon.
All right. Always. Captain's having a pint somewhere. Right. It's usually the crump. The crumpet on the mind there. It's usually the drunk captain that... Hey?
Something slighted about you.
Seems to be villains underneath us. We'll ignore that for now. Yes, it does, as I was really... Before I was really interrupted, it seems to be the drunk captains that always end up going on the adventure with you, innit? Sure, I'll tell you, I don't care. Oh, hello. There's the boat down there. Ahoy there! Well, it's the least grand of the boats, but looks like it'll do the job.
You captain of this tub?
Oh, he's got a telescope.
I'm Skellige bound. Need to get there.
Start swimming. Islanders, the black ones, all attackers in those waters. No one sails the route these days.
Come on. Clans are ready to deal. Leave you alone if you do. Someone's done it. Gotta have.
Not likely. Except maybe that daft bastard Wolverstone from the Atropos. A liar, a thief, and a bugger, that one. He might have parlayed with the sea swine.
Where can I find him?
In a pigsty most times. Others, the golden sturgeon. Ask for Flask, everyone knows him.
Aye, told you. It's the drunk captain we're after. Called Flask, believe it or not, yeah. Wonder what's in that. Tea, I expect. Come on, you mad drunk captain. Where are you? Here we go.
Black ones, the Danians.
Ah. Over there.
You, Wolverstone, captain of the Atropos.
So you want to know if I'm Atropos, captain of the Wolverstone? No fucking clue, mate.
I need to get to Skellige.
My Atropos and me, we're due to sail for Ard Skellige. Carrying grain. But that's our shush. Got any coin?
Arr. Yeah, okay. Damn it, it's a lot of coin.
Hefty sack. Like a bull's. When do we sail?
Not sure you're ready. You can barely stand.
Know this, stranger. Captain Wolverstone never sails sober.
Told you.
Goes one way, Wolverstone the other. Makes the rocking bearable. So, ready to set sail?
We are. Let's do it.
Let's go.
First, we must drink to the wind, to good fortune, and to the strength of my Atropos. Anchors away.
Whoa. There's a view. That's the first time we've seen him have a kip. It's usually when he ends up in a bed, he's with somebody. Whoa, for God's sake. Being boarded there, Witcher boy. Alright. Let's get these heathens off the boat, shall we? Dealt with fairly swiftly.
Reaping the sails.
Whoa. Always sail drunk, eh? It's only part of this game. Sometimes I think the between the cutscenes and everything, it could be so much smoother. Don't need to have long gaps and such like, really. And there's a few stuttery moments between Geralt waking up and having the fight and stuff, weren't there? Price we pay for the graphics, I suspect. Alright, looks like a dwarf to me. Don't do it. Alright. No, it's not a dwarf.
Back off or I'll kill you.
I'm not afeard of dying.
Irish.
See, I've landed on Ord Skellig.
How you figure that?
You're wearing Clan on Crate colors. Ord Skellig's their island.
On the Atropos, were you?
Yeah, thought the captain had a deal with you.
With us? Meaning who exactly? Might have arranged something with Lugos, but crack? Nay. Clearly should have, though. Outlander ships aren't welcome in these waters. What about you? What do you seek in Skellige, eh?
Agreed to meet a sorceress here. Yennefer of Vengerberg. She's supposed to be on Ord Skellig.
There's a witch at Kaer Trolde. Croc's guest. Could be the one you're meeting.
That scorn I hear in your voice.
You've good ears. Folks say this witch has got Croc wrapped around her finger. Orders everyone about. Word is she's vicious at it. But a hag's a hag.
Seen her? Know what the sorceress looks like?
Aye. Wears black and white. If not for her tits, you'd think she was a beached orca. Fact is, even those who see her for a wench would gladly push her out to sea, tits and all.
What's your name?
Steingrim.
Well, Steingrim, I don't like you. In fact, I feel like slapping you.
Go ahead, Drifter. You try. Heimdall!
Had enough?
That was quick.
Best finish me now, because you'll be fucked once I catch my breath.
It was a good fight. That's enough for now.
One punch.
Know the way to Kaer Trolde?
Expect I'll find it.
Head north. Then turn west towards the bay before you come to the bridge. You'll find the Jarl port site today. Your sorceress ought to be there too.
Thanks. So long.
Jesus. Ooh, hello. Look at that out there. Stone of power.
Place of power. Should draw from it.
Hey, it looks like we've actually jumped to level 16 without realising it. Just check that. Yeah, we have. Sweet. So we've actually got an extra slot and a mutagen option as well. Nice going. And we've got 1 point to spend. Hopefully this will give us another one. That'll be two. Gonna have a quick save before we do this. quite a lot's happened. God, it's bloody gorgeous, isn't it? Look at that. Yep, another ability point. An Axis Iron intensity as well. There's going to be loads of stuff lying around here, isn't there, from this shipwreck. Wonder if the captain's still alive. Probably. Drunk captains always survive, don't they? Excuse me, blimey. Must be the sea air, eh? Right. That it? Yeah, there's something behind us, right enough, but I think there's something there as well. Check on board the ship. Alright. Seems to be finding standard glyphs now instead of the lesser ones. Which is quite sweet. Let's check up here.
Siren Den. Gotta ruin it for them.
Oh, god damn it, there's a nest on there already. The hell. There's, oh Jesus Christ, what the hell? Yeah. I'm wondering, I think. Is it dead? No, it's coming back. Bloody awesome. Come on. Let's have it. Whoa. It's one ugly creature. Check that out. Yeah. Nice. So let's loot the nest. Ooh, Greater Stryball Greenstone. I wonder what that does. We've got a level 16 sword that we made as well. Can use. Nice stuff on here.
Medallion's humming.
I know, you've already got it.
It's gotta be.
Blood moss, new herb by the looks of it. Right then, let's have a bit of a save here. That one, I think. So we need to have a look at our character now, because we've got 2 points to spend. In fact, to tell you what we'll do, have a quick look at the inventory first, because we did have this sword to make use of. Pretty sure it wasn't that one. I think it's that one. Mastercrafted Silver Sword. Yeah, it's 35 better than the one we're wearing. There's quite a few swords there that are better, look. But the one we made. And we can put a glyph on it as well. And we just picked up some new ones. That's Axie. That's Ard. Chance to stagger's pretty sweet, isn't it? And it's a greater one as well, 5% chance to stagger. Might go for that. It's lesser, they're all lesser ones. Oh, that's a greater. Attack power, plus 5%. I think, well, the silver sword tends to be used for What was that other one we picked up, that weird one? That's Glyph of Yarden. Poison. Because the Silver Sword tends to be used on beasts rather than humans. I'm wondering... Poison is quite effective. Adrenaline point gain. Chance to freeze. Awesome. That might be worth a try, mightn't it? Yeah, give that a go. Can always take it out if we don't like it. Nice. Wonder if we can make them shatter and stuff. It'd be quite cool, wouldn't it? Well, I think that's probably as much as we can replace for now, because... Saying that, that's a steel sword that seems to be better than the one we've got. But that's a witch hunter's sword that we're wearing. It's got Ardsine intensity and a chance to cause bleeding, so there's nothing too uber on it. I think we might change here. For some reason I thought our sword was more powerful than that. I'm just getting overexcited maybe. What's that top one there? Yeah, it's not as good. Right, so 33 seems to be the better one, doesn't it? It's a level 15 sword as well. Lovely. Think that's about as much as we can do. I'm just wondering how good all of our kits bear, how well it's bearing. 100, 95, 99, yeah, it all seems to be fine. 80. Right. Character. Now, we've upgraded all of these now, so it's a question of what we want to go and do next. There's no mutagen bonus for any of these yellow ones. So... could do the bombs. See what that gives us. So increases poison overdose threshold by 5%. Oil applied to blades gives a 3% chance of poisoning the target on each hit. Time is slowed further 15% when aiming bombs. Every known level 1 alchemy formula increases maximum toxicity. If potion toxicity is above 0, time automatically slows when aiming it. I'd quite like to play with the potions, but I haven't done enough sort of messing around to make use of them, really. We could go for more on the signs and then put them at the bottom with the blue mutagen again. Which would make some kind of sense, because I don't think there's anything in the green one that I would use just now. If your current stamina level is too low, signs can be cast in adrenaline, blah. I think I want to do more with signs, is what I want to do. That's hard. We could do the Axie, couldn't we, for the... Also increases the effectiveness. Yeah, Axie and dialogues, yeah, I want that. So we can start getting extra options in dialogue. And a lot of them, it's like just, you know, you convince them to do it using Ard rather than have to spend coin and everything all the time. That might be pretty useful. So I think I might go for that. I realize it's not a very exciting one because it's not a battle in battle type thing a lot of the time, but... It does have an effect in battle if you're fighting humans, which I always forget about, actually. I never use it. Happy with that. And then let's put it down here. And keep the yellow one on, but... Oh, hang on. Need to put a mutagen on. That's what we need to do. Get a blue one. That's 10% sign intensity, isn't it? 7%. Go for that one for now then. And we can now Put that on. So that's got 7% on it, and that's got 10. What is that though? Greater blue mutagen. And that's just a blue, alright, okay. So we could, in theory, make a greater one. It's possible we might be able to do that in alchemy. No, we don't have enough stuff to do it by the looks of it. You need 3 blue mutagens to make a... yeah, to make a greater one. We, I think we've only got lesser ones. Although, confused as to why we can't make mutagens out of... might as well make that while we're here. Because we should, in theory, be able to make blue mutagens out of the lesser ones, but... oh, I see. We've only got two, that's why. Seems reasonable. We'll pick them up as we go. Right, well, that's it then. So we should have more in the way of options. I'm going to save that now. Right, I hope that wasn't too slow to watch. Sometimes it's quite interesting to see what goes on in the menus. I'm trying not to do it too often. Might as well pick that up. Looks like a new... yeah, it's that, more of that blood moss. Bloody gorgeous down here. Water moving around, the wind swirling. Not sure what that is falling from the sky, is that? It's not snow, is it? Is that Roach? Or just another horse? That is Roach. He's got the new saddle on we won in that horse race as well. Gives us 50 stamina on the horse. Go on, Roach, let's have a ride. I had a ride with Roach for a while, have we? What's that there? Could just be a, some sort of landmark, really. Nothing. Oh, it's the top of the boat. Or a boat. Another crashed ship. Just spotted a chest, I think. Yeah, have a bit of that. Nothing too exciting, but... and another one. Nice. Nice, another runestone. Getting loads of that old black pearl. There was a quest somewhere where we've to help a guy get a pearl, and I thought it was a black one, right enough. And oh, hello. Steel sword. Engram. Yeah, we've to meet him somewhere. It's a side quest. To help him get this pearl for his long-lost love or something. And I'm pretty sure we were to meet him somewhere on Skellige. So, might be. If it looks interesting enough, I'll do it in the Let's Play, but it's not attached to any of the main story, I don't think, so... I may do that off-camera. I'll also have a wander around Skellige when I'm off-camera as well. We'll go straight to Yennefer for now, just get a lay of the land. New marker, can come back here now. It's a whole new area this, so I'm guessing there's a shed load to go and looking at. No, go out. Come round. Wrong way. I need to go back to the mainland as well and maybe try fighting some of these bigger beasts, which we haven't done much of. Oh well, there's a trader in here. It's worth noting for later. Hopefully we'll unlock a few signposts as we go. Oh, triggered some sort of fight there. Here we go. Oh, hang on. Oh, hang on. This might give us a marker up here first. I realise it's not the way to go, but... save us riding everywhere if we can mark, get the markers on the map.
Take it easy.
Definitely a lot going to be going on in these places. Check that out, that's an awesome view. Look at that. Big chasm. The bridge over it and everything. Looks like there's actually a town to the left of us down there as well. May well be where we're meant to be going right now. Yeah, but I've a feeling I might not be wanting to go in here just now. That's awesome. Looks a bit ominous, doesn't it? Oh, there we go, new marker. That's what we're after. Right, I'm not going to go in there yet though, because it's definitely not where we're meant to be. But we can teleport there now, which was the idea. I guess with every... I think it is snow actually that's falling. It's looking a bit snowy in winter, isn't it? It's not lying on the ground yet, but I guess in every RPG you've got to have a boggy area, a snowy area, and a desert area. Cover every aspect. There we go. Take a right, Roach. Beautiful music as well. Travel around too.
Come on.
There, oh, another signpost. Very nice. Whoa. Easy. To go this way, I think.
Go to the port. Bid farewell to King Bran.
Side quest down there. Wait here, Roach. See what's going on.
Our time amongst the living is but the wink of an eye.
Hell's going on down here?
What's left when we are...
Somebody's got it. Is it the king? Hey, it's Jennifer. Is it? No, I'm not sure that is actually. Mother and daughter, maybe.
You need not do this, child.
I know, but I won't.
Is madness. Such a young lass.
Erna should be the one going. They shared a bed longer.
Silence. It is her decision.
Jesus Christ, she's going to burn on the boat with them. It's a bit harsh. well, that's just an insane tradition. I wouldn't ask anyone to do that for me. That's a bit much. And they would only send me sod off anyway. What's the point in asking? Yennefer. Hello, me darling.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. Nice to see you again. The eulogy.
King Bran of Clan Twirsech has embarked on his final voyage. At its end, our glorious ancestors await him. Together they will hunt and raid. They will sit round the fire and praise the deeds of ages past. For now, he lives in our hearts. One day, we too shall stand at his side and face the sea together. That will be a good day.
You knew Bran?
Yes. He was well respected. Unlike his wife.
Skelligar is its clans. In times of war, tradition holds the clans unite under the leadership of their king. We've bid Bran farewell. Time to pick his successor who will lead us against the Black Ones. The gates of Caer Troll stand open to all who hail Bran of Clan Twirsech dear. Mead and meat will be plentiful. During the wake, those who believe themselves worthy of the crown will step forth.
Come to the wake with me.
Gladly. Feasts in Skelligar, so predictable. Slobbering drunks, brazen boasting, and the inevitable rows that result.
Yeah, nothing like the banquets mages attend. Remember the one on Thanet?
You were there. How could I forget? I also remember excruciatingly well what happened after the banquet.
Reading my mind again?
What's more, I like what I see.
Alright.
Did you learn anything in Velen?
Velen. Awful place. Somehow Ciri wound up at the castle of the local ruler, a baron, self-proclaimed. This was after she was injured.
Injured? Was it serious?
Don't think so. Must have recovered because this baron sent her on to Novigrad. Think she was looking for you at the time. These witches Ciri came across, she was lucky to escape them.
Witches?
Creatures, more like. Can't say exactly what they are, but they're dangerous. Very. Also ran into an old friend of ours in Velen, Kira.
What on earth is Kira Metz doing in that wasteland?
Hiding from witch hunters. Listen, she told me an elven mage had been there looking for Ciri.
Good. You'll need to tell me more when we have some time.
Ciri found Dandelion in Novigrad. They met up. They robbed one crime boss and almost killed another. Ciri was looking for something. She needed coin and information. That's all I know at this point. Gotta find Dandelion, talk to him.
So Dandelion knows what happened to Ciri?
Yeah, gotta find him. How about you? What have you learned?
Something strange happened on Ard Skellig a time ago. A disaster brought about by a burst of magic. Extraordinary, really. Natural anomaly. Never seen anything like it. My intuition tells me Ciri was its cause.
As much as I respect your intuition, Yen, we need something specific. Evidence.
I'd know for certain if I was able to inspect the disaster zone. Unfortunately, Ermion and his druids aren't letting anyone near.
Ermion's head of the Skellige Circle. Haven't seen him since...
Since Ciri was a little girl. I doubt he'll do you any favors, not even for old time's sake.
So why won't Ermion let you inspect the area of the anomaly?
Call it a difference of opinion. A large, loud difference. Look, it's Krach.
Wait, Wolf!
Right, hello.
I shall see you at the wake, and I'll not accept any excuses. I've an important matter to discuss with you.
Very well. Nice axe, by the way.
I shall wear black and white for the feast. I count on you to don something complimentary. Something that doesn't reek of a thousand hunts.
Yen, you know I can't stand new doublets. Just too tight till you break them in.
And just like Krach, I'll not accept any excuses. We're not here to enjoy ourselves. We've matters to resolve and should dress appropriately. I've rented a room at the inn. Took the liberty of laying out some clothes for you there. You ought to go. Choose something. In the meantime, I've something to attend to. We'll meet at the entrance to the feast hall.
These women just want to dress me up all the time. I don't know, eh? Want to see my sweet witcher ass in some nice clothing. Absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to say that a lot through these playthroughs. And I have been doing. Whoop whoop. Another quest complete. Meet Yennefer at the entrance to Kara's Trolled Keep. And we need to put on the attire. Righto. Well, folks, I will call it an end to part 19 there. And I shall see you all in the glorious part 20. It's been an honour and a privilege to serve for you once again. And I will see you in the next episode. Take it easy. Bye.